Hello and welcome to a Battlefield 3 commentary gameplay. We're going to be playing some Aftermath maps. This is a Telemarket. You guys know who it is. Your boy, it's Gyro, the console scrub himself. I think we're actually going to be playing some of the TDM and the brand new Aftermath maps. Going to be using the UMP-45, UMP-45. However, you guys would like to pronounce it. You know, everybody has their own pronunciation. And every time I say UMP-45... somebody always has to ask me, now, Gyro, why do you say it UMP-45 whenever it's UMP-45? And to me, it's just easier and faster to say UMP than it is to say UMP. So if you don't like it, then y'all can suck a dick if I care, you know? But anyway, so what are we going to be talking about? Oh, yeah, so we got double EXP going on for all premium members on Battlefield 3 across all systems. PlayStation, Xbox, and PC. It started on the 1st of January, and it's going to end on the 7th of January. So across all maps and modes, it doesn't matter what you're playing on what map or whatever. So we have a new year that we finally came upon, 2013, and all that I can say is that I'm ready for 2013, and I'm ready to put out some fun, awesome, entertaining gameplays and content for you all to enjoy. So my very first thing is, not many of you actually commented below on my montage that I put out, New Beginnings, on what your New Year's resolution was going to be. So if you have a New Year's resolution that you have set for yourself, then please comment below and tell me what it is. Now, I just want to talk a little bit about these Aftermath DLC map packs, since I really haven't done a commentary and talked anything about it and gave you guys my opinions on the map pack itself. So what do I think of the four maps? I would probably say that this is one of the better map packs that they put out compared to the other ones. It's not that I didn't like Armored Kill and I didn't like Close Quarters. I loved the Back to Karkan DLC. I don't know, it just felt like to me that the like Armored Kill, of course, on console, it only being 12v12, you know, it's not all that action-packed as PC. And Close Quarters, it being, you know, the Close Quarters real tiny maps, it really doesn't seem like, you know, you're in that much of a firefight every time that you spawn in a lot of the time. So I don't know, I am definitely enjoying the Aftermath map pack. I want you guys to comment below and tell me, are you guys enjoying the map pack that they've came out with? And also, what do you guys think of in-game that's coming out? There was a premium trailer that we got to see, which is the in-game teaser trailer, and it showed us a few different things, like, of course, the motorcycles, which everybody is waiting for, the two-man motorcycles, wherever you and your friend can spoon together on a dirt bike and spray people in the face, you know, whatever you'd like to do. But only thing that you gotta do, grab on, hold tight to your buddy's waist, and you'll be on your way, you know what I mean? So I don't know, I'm definitely looking forward to in-game. I wonder how they're really gonna put it out there, on if it's gonna be huge maps or not. I mean, of course, they're probably gonna be bigger maps, since they have the AC-130 icon that you saw in the trailer. It was on one of the flags, like they have in the Armored Kill DLCs, you know, for the AC like 130. Now, I don't know if the AC-130 is going to be the same thing as it was in Armored Kill, or if it's just going to be something that, you know, you parachute from like you do the original gunship, just without the guns. I don't know. Hopefully they'll do something with it and make it entertaining. I'm sure they will, because this is going to be the very last DLC until Battlefield 4 comes out, and we only have until March, whenever the very last DLC for BF3 here comes out. And then after that, they're not really gonna be supporting the game all that much, you know. I know that they're probably already working on Battlefield 4 as we speak, you know, and so many people, like I said, still want that Bad Company 3, but I don't think we'll be seeing that until probably after Battlefield 4 comes out. We can only hope. Am I right or am I right? So what I also want to hear from you guys is, what is your favorite map out of the four Aftermath map pack maps here? Do you like Telemarket? What are the other map names? Let me look real quick. Telemarket, Markaz Monolith, Epicenter, and Azadi Palace. So those are the four. I would probably say my favorite out of the four, I do like Tala Market here. I just kind of hate that there's only Conquest Assault on it and not regular Conquest, so it usually makes, you know, the team that has to defend the five territories, if they lose all five, they lose the game. So you definitely had to play this map in Conquest Assault and be really PTFO with your playstyle, because if not, you will lose quickly. It's just, you know, like all of the maps from the back to Karkan, like Wake Island, Shark High Peninsula, with all of the Conquest Assault stuff. So commentary is coming to an end. I hope you guys enjoy. Be sure to comment below. Tell me what your opinions are on all this brand new Battlefield stuff. Also, comment below and tell me what your level is currently in Battlefield 3. I think I'm about to level up to a level 87 colonel. So what's your level, huh? You guys a level 100 yet? Have you been a level 100? And if so, for how long? Or are you about to hit that level 100? Comment below. Hit that like button. Tell me what's up. We'll see you next time. Take it easy. Peace.